Yo, guys. Miami,
second the greatest show in the world.
Yes, sir.
Good run, bro.
Miami, baby.
What's going on, bro? Mm-hmm.
Good to hear for you, buddy.
So, what's up with you guys? What you guys been up to?
Hey, Ryan, that fight, man. You should have won by the knockout, round 7.
Yeah, they robbed that shit from me, man.
100%. The referee was against you the whole time.
Hey, you want to imagine?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
Stop, Eden. Stop, Patriot.
What's up, Xavier? Yeah, I just been busy batting the peasants back with a broomstick saying I told you so. What are you going to do?
We're cracking, y'all. We're cracking.
What's up, Patriot?
Hey, how many people won money?
I had to correct some people in the comments.
I won. I had you against Remy. I'm going to go trash talk Remy later. He's doing his space. I had you.
Like, yeah, what's up, Lila? I don't know why. Can somebody let Lila speak?
Yeah, I got that. I don't see her request. I don't see it. Oh, there it is. I got it. Yeah, just happy for you, man. You deserved it, too. That was a good, clean fight. You kicked his ass.
Hi, Ryan.
Hey, Lila. Hey, Lila was at the fight.
I was. You did so good. I'm so proud of you.
Yeah.
I literally lost my voice because I was screaming so loud.
It was lit.
Hey, people trying to get in the comment section and talking about how you celebrating. It was this Christian guy, and I was like, dog, let the man enjoy his damn, you know what I mean? Like, calm down with that shit, bro. You judging somebody because they celebrating a victory? And then he's talking about you in the comment section about how you celebrating, but he's not talking about how you shot it out, how you still are about the kids, and you was bringing truth to the fight. I don't want to hear this. Man, I don't want to hear that negative shit, man. Like, get out of here with that shit, dog.
Heck. At the end of the day, you know, they're like Pharisees, you know? All I know is you haven't read the word enough to understand that your wisdom is proved by your deeds, not what you consume. You know, as long as I'm doing good by God and putting the work, as far as I know, my wisdom is proven. So until it's proven otherwise, then it is what it is. But praise Jesus Christ.
Hey, Ryan, great fight. Phenomenal.
Thank you, Tony Mo.
What's next? Who's next, I should say?
Well, I got a couple things in mind. I have to – I'm going to step away from boxing for a little bit. I have to go on a tour for music. And then I have to have a meeting with Bibi Netanyahu in Israel, which I'm going to do it within 2 weeks. You'll be seeing that. And then I'm going also to Mar-a-Lago?
Mar-a-Lago.
Yeah, I'm going to that place today. Yeah.
Oh, you're going there today? That's sick.
Yeah, I'll be taking pictures. We're supposed to be leaving in about 30 minutes. So that'd be cool. But got a lot of things ahead. But fight-wise, I either want to fight the 154-pound champion, Sebastian Fundora, or I want to fight Isaac Cruz.
Ooh, that Isaac Cruz fight would be nice.
Yep.
Hey, Ryan, as well, if you go to meet Netanyahu, don't let him brainwash you, innit? Because Elon Musk come back last time waving Israel flags a lot, so you know what he's like.
No, I mean, I'm just here to try to spread the news to, basically, the news of we need to save children, you know?
Facts.
There's a war there, but Let men do men things, but leave the children out of it, is how I always see it. You know, in my opinion.
No, facts, bro. Hopefully you can get a ceasefire in it. No one else has managed to do it, but you never know.
Hey, you think crews will go up to your weight?
He has to if he wanted to make money. So,
that's the truth right there, man, for sure.
I'm the man that could walk away with $30 million in one night. So I call the shots in this position. At the end of the day, I want to give the fans what they want. So if they want me to fight Cruz, so be it.
You're man of the people.
Yep.
Ryan, another thing. Yep. I personally think Devin and his camp are not interested in running it back. Like, I just feel like that was just too dominant of a performance for, you know, all 12 rounds. Do you feel that way? Like, they're just capping with the running it back? Or?
Well, I first got to see if Devin Haney will ever be back the same. But if they want to run it back right away, I mean, it'd be easier this time because now he's damaged good. So I wouldn't mind fighting him. But also, yeah, I mean, if I see my son get his ass whooped like that, I'm not doing no rematch for a minute.
Yo, Ryan, because, you know, it is facts, though, you had full control over that whole fight. When that first, what do you call it, when they were reading out the scorecards at the end in the first
fight, have you ever seen a boxer that went out on a Monday to the club before his fight? And went out to dinner on Thursday, and then went out on Friday, and then turned all the way up on Saturday. No, I
chugged a beer on Friday at weigh-ins. You can't.
Hey, how's that ever been done? I just want to know.
Nobody's never seen nothing like that.
No one's chugged a beer at weigh-ins.
Has anybody ever betted $2 million on themselves and won $12 million?
Not that I heard of, no.
Damn, we breaking records, man.
That's right.
Let's go, shout out.
That's right.
God damn.
The peasants are having aneurysms as we speak. Peasants can't follow your moves.
Bro, nobody followed my moves. It was hilarious. We had Vegas food.
Fact.
Yo, I went and took down the house myself. All that money I lost, I got it back. Oh, answer. Damn, boy. Boys really like that, boy.
Wait, you told him too. You told him you were acting.
Hey, Ryan, who was that guy you was having a back and forth with on Twitter and you said something about coming to London to the O2?
Oh, yeah. Bring on Connor, bitch ass Ben, whatever his name is.
Yeah, you need to come to London.
Steroids Ben. Bum Ben. The Bundam Bum London.
Nah, here's another question.
The London
Bum. Here's another question.
The London
Bum. Did you pay out the 1.5 for the 3 pounds?
I did do that.
Man of his word.
My body could not go lower than 143.
Yeah, punch that guy so hard, he'll walk away from that fight talking like me. He'll sound like this when he talks. Proper English.
No, I think Thank that you. You're giving him too much credit. I think you're giving him too much credit.
The man couldn't talk at all.
The man cannot talk at all, Ethan. Why is everybody laughing at me? Come on, I'm just talking.
I never heard of that guy. I just like talking trash on the greatest show in the world, the Ryan Garcia Show. Back to you.
I'm just kidding, guys. That wasn't my real voice. I was making an accent.
That was a hell of an accent, man. So, Ryan, I want you to walk. I want you to walk me through because I was doing live commentary on the fight. I want you to walk me through the first feeling you got when that left hook landed in the first round. What were your immediate thoughts? Like, I noticed it seemed like, you know, I think, you know, it looks like you kind of took your foot off the gas a little bit to set him up again. But what were your first thoughts when that first left hook landed?
I was like, damn, am I really going to knock him out in the first round? That's comedy. Like, I started laughing in my head. But then I thought to myself, maybe he's going to be knocked out in the second round. But then I was like, he's kind of already recovered, so let me just, like, act like it's just, you know, a regular fight still. So, like, a lot of thoughts went in my head, to be honest.
All right. One more, a couple more questions, if you can. Would you say that you had to make a couple of adjustments to set him up again in the sixth and seventh? Because it looks like he started going under the left hook, and you was timing it perfectly, but Bill Haney directed him to go under the left hook, and it looks like in the sixth and seventh round, you made some adjustments. What adjustments were those?
Well, there's been a good study breakdown on it in YouTube, but basically I had to change speeds. I'm just going to leave it like that, but I can't. I'm not going to give you guys too much.
Appreciate that. Appreciate that, Mr. Yeah. Garcia. another thing was I felt like you it looks like you told Bill Haney to take Devin out of the ring. You was like, hey, look, stop the fight. Did you genuinely care about Devin Haney's health when you told him to stop the fight?
Yeah, at that moment in my heart, I cared about him. He didn't look right in the ring. He had nothing to give me anymore. It was just like, there's no point unless you want your son to get just definitely killed. Like, I guess he does want Devin, you know? It was just weird to me. I just couldn't, I didn't like looking at it, but then I just went back to fighting after he didn't say yeah. So, yeah, I did ask Bill to stop the fight, yes.
If y'all haven't already checked out Mr. Garcia's video on YouTube, that video, I ain't lying, no cap, that video fire. Y'all go check it out. Ryan, tell them about that video you got on YouTube, bro.
Which one?
It came out like 2 days ago. I saw it 2 days ago on YouTube with you and your boy. I forgot what it was called.
Oh, yeah, the music video for Highly Blessed, Highly Favored, or Blessed and Highly Favored. Bro, you guys got to go watch it. It's fire as fuck.
Stream it.
Dude, I met the guy who produced that for you. He was sitting next to me, and then we also, like, bumped into each other at the club. Chris, right?
That's crazy as fuck.
He's so cool.
Yeah.
Also, Showbiz the Adult, man. Shout out to him, Ryan. He called. He actually called what was going to happen in the fight 2 days before and pre-recorded it and then posted the video, man. That shit was crazy. He said exactly what was going to happen.
I got someone in my DM saying Connor Ben that wants to come up.
Oh, yeah, bring that bitch
up. His name is Josh Redwood, and he says he's got Connor with him.
All right, bring that up.
Josh, you hit my DMs if you're listening right now. Go ahead and request.
Yo, he's got Connor with him? Connor's going to tell us about the pageants, bro. What's the guy's name?
Yeah, come on, Connor Ben, you yanker.
Where do I find? Oh, no, the guy you're trying to fight. Oh, that guy? I don't care. I thought you meant Connor McGregor. I don't care about this guy.
Nah, Connor Ben.
What's the guy's name? What guy I got to find the invite?
Josh Redwood.
Squidward? Hold on. I don't know. What's it look like? I don't know.
Connor's a caca brain.
DM me. This is terrible radio talking about this guy. I want to hear this guy's funny accent. Back to you.
Bring on caca brain. I just fucking with you guys.
Yo, whose idea? What did you think about that string quartet? That was sick.
What do you mean?
I'm just saying, nobody's ever seen anything like that. The string quartet in the locker room. That was amazing.
Oh, yeah. That was awesome. Yeah, that was sick. It's cool. I came up with that idea.
That's sick. That's the future of entertainment. That's the greatest show on the earth right there.
Thank you. No, we are the greatest show on earth.
It is. Hey, one more thing I wanted to put out there, though. You went against the grain on this, Ryan. It looks like the ref was trying to rig the fight. It looks like he was giving Haney, extra time to get up and kept pulling you off when it was unnecessary. He docked that point from you that we all know that he should have at least given you a warning. Did you feel at any time in your mind in this fight that the ref, Harvey Duck, whatever his name is, was trying to rig the fight?
I never got that feeling, but looking back, it was like, what the fuck, bro? Like, you took a whole ass point away from me, bro.
Yeah, but what about when they read the score?
No warning, nothing, just straight. Took a point from me. Devin Haney was finished. I was going in for the finish, and he couldn't break us up. So I tried to punch with my free hand, and he said break, and I just punched him. I mean, he held me for over 20 seconds, and he didn't call Devin Haney once. You feel me?
And then the ref said that he was gonna point deduct for the holding, and he never did. Like, and that was in the eighth round when he said it, and he just let it happen like for the last four rounds.
Who the fuck was that judge? Who the fuck was that judge that scored the fight 112-112? I want to kick his ass.
Right.
I need to put my foot in his ass. No pun intended. I'm just saying.
Yeah. No diddy. That was crazy.
Yeah, none of that. We're not doing none of that. None of that. Is it true that Devin Haney, you know what he could use now after that ass whooping you gave him? What does he need to do? He needs to like sit in a pool, maybe, like in a hot tub, maybe at a pool party. Maybe he needs to go spend some time doing that. How's that sound? Back to you.
Yeah.
I think Devin Haney needs to sit out for a little minute. Let it heal. Let his face heal. No pun intended. I'm just saying it's a protocol.
No, man, I don't think Devin Haney can fight more than 3 months. I think he got suspended for 3 months.
Right, I think he needs to take a longer layout than that,
or at least 3 weeks.
And to Bill Haney, I just want to say, man. I mean, I know you're a father, man, but I would have took him. I know y'all want to, you know, quit on y'all shield, but your son, man, he gotta make it to live another day. Next time, don't let that boy take that much punishment, man. That's not safe. The ref wasn't trying to protect him. Nobody was trying to protect him, Bill. You got to protect him. Next time, you have to protect him when that happens. You dig what I'm saying? He could have died in there, bro. If Ryan was a killer, he could have killed him. I'm just saying, it's not good. He was out on his seat the whole time.
And he was. And he wasn't there after, like, the 10th round. I didn't feel nothing in him anymore.
Yo, you know what I would have did? I would have had the string quartet ringside. And then every time you knock Devin Haney on his ass, then the strings would be playing that sad music. Back to you.
Yeah, you're just a guy in the band.
Facts. Bro, I'm having too much fun. It's the greatest show on earth. Let's go.
Woo! Hey, Ryan, go watch that video with Charleston White. Did you see Charleston?
I didn't see that.
You got to go ahead, Charleston.
Bro, there's so many funny shit out there. It's fucking insane, bro. I have so many memes in the back of my pocket, bro. It's fucking crazy.
Yeah, Showbiz was comparing you to Ali with your tactics that you were doing. I don't think you knew it, bro. I don't think you knew it, but you did.
No, I seen it later. Remember I told you games? I was like, I didn't even, like, what is, I didn't try to repeat nothing of what Muhammad Ali said. I didn't even think that he had tact. I didn't.
It was just in you, man.
It was just in me, bro. Nice.
But yeah, I mean, that was, hey, bro, that was, like, that was great. Like, you know, it's like, you do the comparison. You got this picture where you, like, standing over Devin Haney, kind of similar to the Ali pose when he was it Sonny Liston he was standing over? It was crazy. Yeah. And it's the same type of storyline. He was trolling. He was doing all the shit he was doing. And nobody was taking it serious. The odds with him was, like, I think 8-1. Yours was 11-1. And it was, like, so crazy, bro.
Damn, bro, that's crazy. I was a big underdog.
I mean, I told him, boys, not to sleep on you like that, though. I tried to tell him the weigh-in day, I was like,